I've got a riddle for you. What's gray and white and marble all over? If you guess this bathroom, you are correct.
It's reveal time at the ranch. You've already seen the kitchen, the living room, and the dining room. So today, I'm going to show you the main bathroom. But before I show you the bathroom and talk more about our design life, you know I always say that no 2 days are ever the same. So while I was here putting finishing touches on these rooms, I want to give a quick shout out to the Minister of Exteriors and tell you a little bit about his aviation life.
So Denny, what are we up to today?
We are delivering 30 cases of our hand sanitizer to the Sudbury Hospital today.
Our friends at the Georgian Bay Spirit Company are doing their part during the pandemic by producing hand sanitizer, and Alex is helping out with delivery.
I think we've produced about 24,000 bottles. We've been donating them to hospitals, first responders all over the province, and this is our second to last delivery. Alex is flying it up to Sudbury for us today in the spirit of the sky. Ready to roll.
Was it hard to actually change from producing alcohol to producing hand sanitizer?
The process wasn't difficult. We had to get some licenses from Health Canada, which took about 2 weeks, which they've expedited all their hand sanitizer licensing because of COVID. So once we had our license, it was, you know, I think it took us about a week and a half or 2 weeks to produce all 24,000 bottles. So it wasn't a tough transition. We just had to order a few more chemicals that we don't normally have in the distillery, and ready to go.
Kudos to my Minister of Exteriors. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, if you want to get your hands sanitized, have I got a room for you.
You know all about this room. It's the main bathroom. We've all spent tons of time in here during the course of the renovation.
As soon as you have a meeting and are outnumbered by men in a bathroom, you know what happens? Well,
toilet talk happens.
It all goes kind of potty.
You know, this is my first bath with Chris.
Yeah?
First of many.
We made some big changes. Big change number one was we made the room bigger. So this bathroom's very brown. We've got a tub shower combo, and Braden on our construction team had the great idea that if we closed off the front door, which I wanted to get rid of, and gave the space that used to be a hallway to the bathroom, it would make the bathroom live a lot larger.
The question is, should we open up this wall so we can look at taking this space over as the bathroom?
Okay, that was all amazing. We got more space. But then, if you're trying to renovate and stay on a budget, you really need to work with what you've got and make the best of the available features. So, in terms of fun features, we have this great dramatically sloped roof line inside the bathroom. What this meant was, once we got the extra space that used to be on a lower level, we had lower ceilings. So you know what we did? We sunk the tub. And that keeps the line feeling open throughout this bathroom. It gave us the bonus added feature of a gorgeous new bathtub sunken beneath the pair of windows, and it still provides ample headroom if you stand up in the bathtub, because that's kind of an important consideration.
Well, I'm thinking that maybe this is the other thing. You get out of the tub and you're like drying off your feet and all that sort of stuff, and you give them the road quite a show.
We're gonna frost them so they're privacy.
We tried to keep as much of the plumbing in the same place as it originally was as possible, because that is a great way to save money. So the shower now is where the tub shower combo used to be, and the sink in the vanity is exactly where it started. And anytime you can save money and still achieve your design goals, I think that makes great sense. When it comes to the shower, we decided to feature marble slab walls, and wow, what an effect it is.
Adam is a slab of marble.
I'm a little crooked, but yes, basically right here.
Slabs of marble don't talk, and they're very still. Perfect.
So this main bathroom also serves as the powder room. There is another bathroom in the ensuite. You're gonna have to stay tuned and see that in another episode. And a third bathroom, which is on the lower level. But this bathroom functions both as the bathroom for the two bedrooms nearest to it, as well as a powder room. So I wanted this space to be as crisp and clean and contemporary as possible. Let's look at this tub deck. Do you see what's happening here? There is a piece of Carrara marble on the face of the bathtub, and then there is a slab of pure white Caesarstone on the top. And you know what happens? Those two pieces are mitered together, completely seamless. this tub deck was brought in one piece, ready to go, slid into place. Doesn't this look gorgeous? I really love this feature. I did this once before. The first time I did this was on Sarah Off the Grid season 2 in the kitchen. I took a leftover strip from our big statement backsplash marble wall and I mitered it onto the counter. And I told you then that I would do it again and voila! This was my next experiment with combining two distinct materials. And I really think it works. So I want you to check out that detail. And in this bathroom, you'll notice we've gone with satin, brass, plumbing, and details throughout. When you come into this bathroom, the predominant feel is of the horizontal, from the horizontal windows, from the tub, from the way the floor tile is set. So for the shower floor, I decided to reinforce that with a stacked mini brick pattern, also in Carrara marble.
What do you piglets think? Is everything good in here? If they're approving of that shower floor, who needs Sarah when you've got two cute guinea pigs to approve everything?
So just keep layering those simple details one onto the next. It really felt like this was a bathroom for restraint. When you're working with a house that has interesting architectural lines, like these strong sloped roof lines, I think you have to embrace it and you have to think about how to have fun with it and make it a feature. So I did just that. We have a vanity that is 6 feet wide, and this is made of two IKEA wall hung vanity components, a 48 inch with a 24 inch beside it. I don't mind that it's asymmetrical. I actually really like that. And then, because it sits directly beneath this sloped roof line, I decided to give it a sloped backsplash. I mean, why not? Never done that before, but there's a first time for everything. I also put the same detail at the end of the tub. And I'm not sure everybody will notice. It's just a little wink, a little nod for me about embracing what was here and taking inspiration from a fun feature. And speaking of fun, I thought it would be fun to have an articulating wall sconce that's a combination of enameled white with a little tiny band of brass that can be adjusted and moved out, that's mounted directly above the mirror. It's not serious. It's not what you might normally choose for a wall sconce in a bathroom, but hey, I think it's fun. Speaking of fun, check out these half moon cabinet knobs. They're crisp, they're modern. I have said crisp so many times today, I don't know what other word to use. And right now, somewhere out there, Tina Magnuson owes me a big sip of wine. I think this bathroom would pair well with a Chardonnay. But back to the cabinet knobs. These are modern chic. They feel really nice in your hand. There's lots to hold on to when you're opening the vanity doors. But if you're thinking about how to punch up the style factor of a simple, flat-faced, in-stock vanity, I'm telling you, statement hardware. Go gorgeous. Get something that really adds some bling to that vanity and dresses it up because it takes it to a whole nother level. You'll notice the cabinet at the end of the vanity is raised. It's at a different height and it's also at a different plane. It's shallower, it's taller, it has tons of storage inside. There is so much storage in this bathroom, it's crazy. So that's it. This bathroom, we spent so much time in this bathroom throughout the renovation process. It seemed to be where the whole renovation crew would meet every single Friday. Why do we always end up in the bathroom on Friday afternoon?
Very good. Valentine's Day.
Can I get a Valentine's Day hug from you guys? It's like you're under the mistletoe. It's the light. It's the Valentine.
Aww.
Oh, there we go.
Aww.
We had a lot of laughs in here. But at the end, it is truly a sum of the parts of some really fun architectural features like the skylight, like the sloped ceiling, like the sunken tub, and then simple materials, a restrained palette, and voila, this main bathroom is complete. Want to see more bathrooms? Because I have two more fabulous bathrooms coming your way that I would love to share with you on the tour of our Retro Ranch Reno. Click the button and subscribe so you'll know the second we launch a new episode and you won't miss a thing.